That's all.
Sure doesn't.
My name is Joel. I own Working Man's Armory, and I'm here because we've built a pretty nice relationship with the guys from 299 as well as and the team, you know, obviously headed or corralled by Glen Tate as much as he can. Working Man's Armory is a company I started. Basically, I have an affection for the AK platform. I've been an instructor for ARs for several years now with a local police department. I've served overseas where I instructed Afghans in their use of their AMD-65, which is a Kalashnikov variant, and I really grew to love and respect the AK as a weapon, both in its simplicity and its durability. Started building AKs 2007-ish, and really fell in love with the fact that they take a lot more skill and a lot more effort to build than your standard AR.
Not as much skill and effort.
Not as much skill and effort to shoot, but definitely more effort to put together. And there's a real craft behind it. And I saw some issues with the AK that I didn't think were bad, but could be improved upon. And so I sort of set out on a mission to make my small improvements to the Kalashnikov, hoping that I'd come up with a good design. We do ARs as well. We have a line of billet ARs. We started with lower receivers. Went through a few different evolutions on design and have finally settled on one that we're going to put into production as far as built rifles go. We've sold stripped receivers in the past, but now our focus is trending towards the complete rifle that's ready to go out of the box. It's a really high quality piece. We use only the best components that we can source domestically. We try and purchase from smaller companies that put a lot more pride into their product. And because we're a smaller business, we really want to support other smaller businesses around the nation by purchasing their products. So the goal with our ARs is, again, to provide an extremely high quality, accurate, reliable AR-15 at a price that's significantly below some of the top tier brands out there right now. When it came down to it, it was easier just to go ahead and start a business. And that morphed over the years into me really focusing on trying to provide quality weapons at reasonable price to the average working man or woman out there that was looking for a high quality weapon that maybe on the normal or larger company might be out of their price range. There's a slogan actually a friend of mine came up with, and he did a really good job at it. It's black rifles for blue collars. Black rifles being the generic term for the AKs and the ARs and the modern sporting rifles, as they've come to be called. And again, our focus is getting quality into the hands of somebody who might normally not be able to afford quality. Your average working class guy, which is what I've been my entire life. I've been a street cop. Contracted a little bit, but never raking in the six digits that everybody wants to rake in. So for me, affording a rifle, especially when I started out, was a tough prospect. I mean, you had to save several paychecks. You buy what you think you want, pay a lot of money for it, buy what you think you need to add on to it, pay a little bit more money for it, and finally you've got a lot invested in a product that you're not really sure is what fits your need because you don't really know exactly what you want when you're new to the game. So our goal is to pre-think for some of our customers who don't know exactly what they want and provide them with a rifle that's of a quality on par with some of the top rifles out there, but at a price that's affordable on the average paycheck. So we pay very close attention to the materials that the products are made of, where they're sourced from, durability, and everything else that makes the difference between a inexpensive starter rifle and a expensive rifle that's out of their price range. So what we've come up with is basically a grab-and-go kit. I wanted to provide a rifle package that when the customer, whether he's very knowledgeable or she is very knowledgeable, or they have no clue and this is their first AR ever, I wanted to provide a kit they could literally pick up off the ground, add ammo to, and go shoot. So the idea behind the 17th Irregular Rifle, or the 299 Days kit, was to provide a grab-and-go rifle kit for someone who maybe doesn't know every in and out of the AR-15 system, maybe is new into shooting and really just wants to buy one piece of equipment and be able to go to the range with it. And we wanted to have a rifle that could be comfortable on the range, comfortable on a bench target shooting, and comfortable as a home defense or a civil defense type weapon. So the kit that we're putting together is a 16-inch AR mid-length gas system built on our billet receivers, high quality barrel, high quality lower parts, like I said, all domestic, no imported parts. And along with the rifle, which is engraved with the 17th Irregulars logos, it comes in a Pelican case, fully waterproof, ready to go. Comes with 10 magazines, aimpoint, scope, a sling, and pretty much everything that you need without ammo. So pick up a box of ammo, buy this kit, head to the range, start shooting. All the research has already been done for you. We've sort of determined what we think is the best application for the money and already included in that kit. When you buy an inexpensive AR-15, you really do get what you pay for. You've got barrels that are made out of a lower grade steel. You've got parts that were probably imported from China and may or may not meet the specifications outlaid for those parts. You don't know what the quality of metal that those parts are made out of, and you really don't even know how they were assembled. With our rifle, your quality control and your assurance that this is a quality piece is me. I hand build every single rifle that comes out. I only do a limited number of rifles at a time. So everything that you get has my name and my passion for the sport and for the rifle in it. And again, I know who I'm selling to, and because you're dealing with me, when you have a problem or an issue or there's something that you don't like, pick up the phone, call me, and we'll take care of it. I'm not out to steal anybody's money. I'm not out to make $1 million doing this. I don't want a 10,000 square foot warehouse and 40 employees. I want me. I want to hand build every single one of these rifles that I can and get them out to people who really deserve to have something nice to enjoy in their off time and also for defensive purposes in their home. There's a lot of law enforcement agencies out there who allow patrol rifles, personally owned patrol rifles, for duty use. And again, when your life is on the line, or somebody else's life, more importantly, is on the line because of you and your rifle and the situation that you're trying to get them out of, you don't want a cheap rifle or a poorly made rifle that may end up jamming, that may end up failing, that may not be accurate to the standards that you need it to be when seconds count. I love working with cops one-on-one to build them the duty rifle that they want at a price that they can afford on a cop's paycheck, which, having been a cop for 16 years, I'm aware how crappy that is. So, you know, if I can work with a law enforcement agency or a law enforcement officer to build them the best rifle that they can get, we're gonna do it, even if it doesn't make me as much money as it would somebody else. my cousin handed me a book a couple years ago called 299 Days and said, you need to read this. Because it's a great book. And so I read it, and it is. It's a great book. It's a wonderful story. It's a very plausible story, which is a little bit of a sidestep from normal books in that genre. I saw on the 299 Days website that Glen Tate was asking people who worked gun shows if they would pass out his flyer for his book series at the gun show. I don't do gun shows, but I did email him and offer him, say it, and said, listen, I'll put them in the boxes that I ship out if you want me to. That's not a problem. And got a response back, and just through email chains back and forth, we sort of formed a working relationship there that I think is really going to lead to some great things for both of us. It's a great group of human beings. Between myself as the owner of WMA, Glen Tate, and the rest of the team, we can conspired, if you will, over several conversations as to what we thought would be good on this rifle and what would be perfect for the public for this rifle. These are all working class guys. We don't have anybody here that I've seen so far that has made it obvious that's raking in, you know, 6-7 figures a year or more here. These are all humble, down-to-earth guys. Everybody seems very friendly. Everybody seems to get along. Nobody seems to have a head on their shoulders that's too big for their body. And these are guys that live just like the rest of us. Your paycheck goes to paying for life. Your paycheck goes to paying for your kids. Your paycheck goes to putting food on the table and making that car payment and that insurance payment every day. And so what little you have left in that paycheck, you don't want to, when you have a hobby or a passion such as the shooting sports or such as working together as a cohesive team like this, you don't want to spend what little money you have left and get junk and then have to spend even more money to go replace that thing that didn't fulfill your expectations. So what I really hope is that I'm putting out a product that guys like these, your average everyday working class guy, is gonna spend the money on and be happy with for 10, 15, 20 years, the rest of his life. If you saw him in a crowd at the mall, you'd walk right by him and not even know it. You see him out on the range, it's an impressive sight. And it's not just the gear, it's the mentality. You can wear as much tack gear as you want, you can have the coolest plate carrier and the most up-to-date sling system and the most badass hat with Velcro on the front of it. And if you can't back it up with action, if you can't back it up with attitude, it's not gonna do you any good. These guys can back up all the cool gear they wear and all the cool gear they don't wear with the attitude and the ability that becomes them.
That is amazing.
That's insanity.
That is physics.